Hi, how's everyone doing today? I'm back here today and I'm gonna play Trouble by Coldplay. And I would love if you guys would stick around to the end of the video so I talk about my impressions, why I like this song so much. And yeah, and then we can discuss the lyrics. Right now, if you're new to my channel, I'm just bringing songs that are dear to me, that are that's like part of my life, or songs that I think the lyrics has something to say. But I would love also to bring songs that you guys gonna recommend, or songs that you think that the lyrics are awesome, that would like to discuss with other people, and you want more people to know about. I'd love to bring here too, so we create a community. That's that was the whole point of this channel. I'd love that we all play ukulele, which is an easier instrument to play. It's so fun, and also discuss lyrics. It's that's the idea. So anyway, those are the chords that is gonna be in Trouble in the song. Majorly the melody, like you're gonna hear Trouble if you play the G, the E minor, and the B minor. Those are gonna be the chords that are gonna be repeated more often during the song. So also in the verses, you're gonna find the F and the A minor. The chorus is going to be between the A and the E minor, going back and forth. And finally, at the end, as the song kind of fades and slows down, you're going to have the F sharp minor. So those are the chords. I like to show first so you can practice the transition before the play along. Maybe you can pause the video and practice. I had a little bit of a hard time going from the G to the E minor. I had to practice a little bit, but it shouldn't be that hard of a song to play. It's very slow, and I think it's you guys gonna be able to play no problem. Let's go for the G. And but if you guys already know this, the chords, you could skip to the play along. Then I'm gonna put the time below. All right, so the G chord, it's an old friend. So it's like the first finger on the second fret of the C string, the second finger on the second fret of the A string, and then you're gonna have your third finger on the third fret of the E string. That's the G. And then we're gonna have an E minor. That's like kind of a little bit like stairs like this. So the E minor, you're gonna have your first finger on the second fret of the A string, and then you're gonna have your second finger on the third fret of the E string, and you're gonna have your third finger on the fourth fret of the C string. That's an E minor. And then you're gonna have the B minor 7. The B minor 7, you're gonna fret the C, the E, and the A string on the second fret, like this. And usually I use my third finger here on the fourth fret of the G string. This is a B minor. Sometimes, I guess because I play guitar for such a long time, I tend to put my finger like that. You don't really need to if it gives you a little, how can I say, more stability. You can do that. So I think that's why I do it. But you really don't need to bar the whole fretboard. But when you see my play along, I do that. And which doesn't interfere, because since you're fretting this one, it doesn't matter if this one here, it's pressing down. So so that's the B minor 7. And then we're going to have the F, which is another old friend of ours. That's the first fret, first finger on the first fret of the E string. And you're going to have your second finger on the second fret of the G string. So that's an F. A minor, super easy, just your for easier transition, you could put any really finger here, but to be easier to go to other chords, you have your second finger on the second fret of the G string. That's A minor. And then you're gonna have an A, that basically you're just gonna do this and add this finger here. So you already have your second finger on the second fret of the G, and you put your first finger on the first fret of the C. That's an A chord. And finally, the last chord that's gonna be played, like I said, just at the end of the song, it's gonna be the F sharp minor, which is gonna be your first finger on the first fret of the C string, and then you're gonna have your second finger on the second fret of the G string and your third finger on the second fret of the E string. It's like this. It's almost like the G7 that we learned how to play, but you move over like you started on the G string. So those are the chords. They are not so hard. You're gonna have to practice a little bit over there, the B minor. But I think it's a fun song to play and just really practice the transitions. Cause like I said, in the beginning, I had a hard time, but just practice, you're gonna get there. So I see you guys for the play along, and I'd love if you guys stay to the end for the discussion. Hi everybody, I hope you guys enjoyed bringing the dog outside. Hope you guys enjoyed the play along of Trouble by Coldplay. I think Trouble was the song that I think consolidated for me, at least, that Coldplay would be like one of those bands that will come to this day after the big success of Yellow. I thought that they would be kind of one of those one hit wonders, and look how many years they've been active and now they are really amazing. So I really enjoyed the song because I think it gets out of that most of the songs that we kind of complain about, things that other people did to you, and it seems Trouble kind of reversed that a little, taking like responsibility for something bad that you did to somebody. And I just like in the sense that he uses the image of a spider web to convey the message that's how we feel. And I thought that's such a powerful image, because that's how we feel when we did something bad to somebody, or if you get like start a lie, it seems that you always get caught in the middle, like you seem always that you get stuck in the position. And if you think about it, like if it's an insect that got trapped on a spider web, that's it for the insect. It's like a very lonely position that it can, there's nothing that you can do about it. So I really think that was a very good image to bring out this idea that he seems like to have done something bad to this person, to have caused trouble or some kind of harm for that person, and that's how he feels. Of course, there's assuming here that he did something bad. Sometimes we just feel, it can be many situations, sometimes we feel that we are causing trouble to somebody by just like sometimes sharing our problems, or when we are depressed, we don't want to bother other people. So we don't know exactly the situation, but I think that the feeling of being trapped and kind of with no way out in a very lonely position that the spider web brings to mind, I think it's it's a very powerful. So that's it. I know that some of my videos I ramble and ramble about the lyrics like for a long time, but it's something that I really enjoy to discuss, verses and ideas and things like that. So so if you like the idea, if you like the idea of the channel, the concept of the channel, if you could give me a like or consider subscribing, that would be really cool. And other than that, just leave me a message about future songs that you would like to see discussed here. It would be really really nice to have a community around this. So have a great day, everybody. Bye.